Okay, well, welcome everyone to the Water Network Management webinar series. My name is Arun Brara. I'm publisher of Indian Infrastructure Magazine. And we were at the conference in April, as you all recall, and in person. But because of COVID, I postponed that. But in order to continue this engagement, we decided to do a webinar series. And we have already done one session with Ms. Tara, Joint Secretary Amput. We also did a session, ULB perspective, where we had Hyderabad and Bangalore last. And today we are going to focus on metering, and we have a great panel with us. And I'm going to introduce one of you guys, but before I do that, I just want to mention my gratitude to Census, which is a Xylem company, for making this possible. There's no such thing as free lunch, and someone has to pay for it, so they're paying for it. Thank you very much, Mr. Beth. Let me briefly introduce the people now, and this is in alphabetic order, the panel. Mr. P. Gopalakrishnan is team leader of water supply project at Coimbatore City Municipal. In the past, he was president of Tamil Nadu Water Supply and Drainage, with that, and now he's joined Coimbatore City Municipal Corporation. He is a civil engineer and also has a degree in structural engineering as well. Mr. Sanjay Gupta is civil, New Delhi Municipal Council, and he's in engineering services, has 1.5 decades of experience, from reputation to NDMC from CWD, and he too is a civil engineer by training, and he looks after roads, water supply, and sewage systems in NDMC. Mr. Nathan Gupta, I'm assuming, Sending engineer water supply at Pune Municipal Corporation. He has nearly 30 years of experience, and at PFC he has been working with roads and sewage departments. Mr. Praveen Kumar is the Deputy Engineer Operations at Kerala Water Authority, has about 2 decades of experience. In the past, has worked with the private sector as well, Ashok Leyland and Escorts. He's an environmental civil engineer, has a master's degree in mechanical engineering. Mr. Virendra Kumar is Chief Engineer of Water Authority, the Retail Board, has about 2 decades of experience and handling water maintenance and consumer projects. In the past, he's worked in Haryana. He's a civil engineer, but also has disaster management as well. Mr. Poman is a information technology officer from Kinchwad Municipal Corporation, has about 30 years of experience in currently handling the smart city mission for PCMC as the joint CEO. And he has a diploma in, advanced diploma in, and he's currently on several awards in the past, including National Rehabilitation. Mr. Abhijit is studying for Census, Xylem brand, and he has over 2 decades of experience in energy and utility sector, and has been working in the area of smart metering and advanced metering infrastructure for utilities across sectors. So that's the panel. And Mika, could you tell me who is still not joined us? Mika?
Mr. Jatta has not joined us, Alok.
Okay.
But he did join us half an hour ago, so we'll just get him to join.
Okay. And Mr. Gopalakrishnan?
Mr. Gopalakrishnan is there, but we're not able to switch on the camera, Alok.
Okay, no, but he's able to hear.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
When I switch on the camera, I get a message, all webcam spaces are currently being used. Please wait until the screen opens and then try again. This is the message I am getting.
Okay, all right. Okay, then I think what we can do is, let me see if I switch off my camera. Hesitant to do just something wrong. We're able to then see you. Try that. Switch off my camera. Are we able to get Mr. Gopal? Mr. Gopal, will you try switching on now? Because I switched off my camera. That has not helped. Okay.
Yeah, I'm on.
Yeah, it is. Okay, wonderful. So I'll keep my camera off, sir. Okay. Cameras here. Okay, this is the first day we didn't go to webinar. We prefer Zoom, but with all the issues that some people have talked about. Okay, so let's start the panel discussion, and let's begin with Mr. Virendra Kumar, Mr. Virendra, my first question to all of you is going to be, what is the current level of metering in your area? Are all the households metered? And are there households that are not metered? And how much of the supply is metered and how much of the supply is not metered? Mr. Kumar, if I can come to you first.
In Delhi Jal Board, we have a... boss, main thodi der mein call karunga. Thank you. In Delhi Jal Board, we have a consumer base of around 24.5 lakh, 24, 25 lakh consumers. So okay. Out of those, we are able to bill the consumer on actual meter reading around 16 lakh. So there is a gap of our estimation, there are about 30 to 35% meter are defective as on date.
Oh, okay. And how much of the supply is metered? And how much the supply is unmetered?
We on an average supply 935 MCD water. This is peak, actually, you can say. This is 935 is peak and average may be around 900 MCD.
Okay.
And we are billing around 500 MCD. Around, say, 54%.
Okay, so 54%
of what we are able to bill. 55.
What kind of meters are you currently using, Mr. Kumar?
We are using basically mechanical meter only. Some we procured 3 lakh meter AMR water meter sometime in 2014-15. 3 lakh.
Okay. How many AMR, sir?
3 lakh.
3 lakh AMR.
Yes.
And okay, so just I wanted to get a sense of where everybody is and then I'll come back to the future part of it. Mr. Gupta, if I can go to you next. Same question. How many households of yours are metered? How much of supply is metered? And what kind of meters are you using right now? Sir, I'm not able to hear you, so you have to unmute yourself. Bega, can you help out here? There is a, on the control panel, there is. Because we were able to hear
on
you earlier.
On the right side of the control panel, there is an icon for mic, if you can switch it on.
But just about 5 minutes ago, we were able to hear you.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now I'm audible.
Yes, sir.
I'm audible now.
Yes.
Yeah, so we have all metered connections in NDMC.
Right.
We have 24,000 meters right. Connections, metered connections. And these, all the meters are mechanical meters, digital meters, okay. No AMR meters, no AMI meters. And these meters are installed around 6 to 7 years back. So all needs replacement. And we are going for AMI meters.
Thank you. Sorry?
So we are getting water from DGB and we are supplying in our area, NDMC area. So all the 19 meters, bulk meters of DGB are sensor based, where online reading is taken every day.
Okay.
The input is metered, online metered, but output connections 24,000. All the meters are mechanical meters.
Okay. If I can go to Mr. Poman now. Mr. Poman, could you tell us about your area? Same question.
Sir, in Munshur Corporation here, can you audible?
Yes, sir.
Municipal corporation area, there are 1,40,000 household meters and commercial meters are 13,000. So all are mechanical meters, but in the distribution and mains, having electromagnetic flow meters. So all these meters are procured at the time of the JNRM in between 2012 to 2014. And the all meters are working now. But basically, we in the smart city, we are going to have a plan to make this meter AMR with the housing society and where is the bulk consumers are there. So only 10 to 15% area are not covered by the meter. Rest of the area in the Pimpri Chinchwad are covered by this metering.
Thank you. Mr.
Gopala
Krishnan, could you tell us about
Coimbatore?
Yes, sir.
I am Gopala Krishnan. I am in charge of the project management consultant for 24/7 water supply projects for Coimbatore Corporation. I don't have data for the full corporation. The project, the 24/7 project is water supply project is implemented in the old city area. That is 60 watts out of the total 100 watts.
Sir, could you come closer to the mic? Could you come closer to the mic?
In the project area,
right,
we have 150,000 house service connections. All of them are needed, but the accuracy and working condition is not known. And all of them are mechanical meters. They are all owned by the individuals, that is consumers. Now, as part of the project, we plan to replace all the meters. The concession agreement provides for AMR enabled meters. We are yet to take a decision on metering technology or the data communication technology. We are having a trial with on a trial basis. Recently we have installed 50 electromagnetic meters and 50 mechanical meters, but those mechanical meters are yet to be provided with a SIBL for communication, AMR communication. We are thinking of different options like manual meter reading, AMR, that is walk by or drive through meter reading, or AMI. We are yet to take a decision. Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Praveen, same question for you. How much of your how many of your households are metered? How much of your supply is metered? What kind of meters are you using?
Good afternoon, sir. Actually, in Kerala Water Authority, as of now, we have around 26 lakhs connections. Besides, we have supply through street fountains, that is public taps. In the case of connections, all 100% connections are metered because we have inherited the legacy from the British supply, maybe because we started the water supply in 1914. First water supply in Kerala is 1914 started. So our policy is that all the house connections are metered, whether it is domestic, non-domestic or industrial. Only the house, the public taps for street fountains are exempted. And the meters are brought by the consumers. And if the meter is not working, we are charging surcharge. Because if we give notice and they are not replacing the meter within a reasonable period, even 100% surcharge will be there. So every time we have a percentage of not working meters well below 5%. So as of now, the percentage of not working meters is 3%. So I can say we distribute around the production capacity is around 3000 MLD, and we distribute around anywhere between 2700 to 2000 MLD water. So only up to some 2.5 to 3 MLD is distributed through street taps. So basically that means more than 99% is metered.
Okay.
And there are mechanical meters, class B multi-jet meters.
All right. Megha, has Mr. Jagtap joined or is he joining later? Megha, are you able to hear me? No.
Alok, he's joined us.
He's joined us, okay.
Yes.
Mr. Jagtap, welcome. Question for you, sir, is what is the, in your area, how many of the households are metered, how much of supply is metered, and what kind of meters are you using? Yeah, Mr. Jagtap.
Okay. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, sir.
Hello.
My question. We can hear you, sir.
Hello.
My question.
I'm from Pune. I'm from Pune Municipal Corporation. In our city, now we are supplying water through meter for only commercial properties. That properties are around 40,000 properties are there. And from now, we have planned to install the 100% metering. And we have floated the tender and we have procured the meter and we have started the installation process as on today.
And how many meters sir?
We need to install total 325,000 meters. Out of that, as on today, we have installed around 11,000 meters.
All right. And have all 325,000 been procured?
Yeah, out of 325,000, I think tender has been floated for all all meters, but contractor has supplied up to, I think, 1.2 lakh meters they have supplied. And out of that, 11,000 are installed. And we are integrating that all that meters are AMR meters from Xylem only. And now we are in process of integrating that meters to our billing system.
Okay, all right. Okay, I'll come back to you again, sir. Let me go to Mr. Kumar. Mr. Kumar, what has been the, what is your opinion or perspective on smart metering, Mr. Virendra Kumar?
Pardon, please, beg your pardon.
Yeah, this is the question is to Mr. Virendra Kumar. Mr. Kumar, if you are there. I guess he is in and out. Let's go to Mr. Sanjay Gupta. Mr. Gupta, what's your perspective on smart meters, relevance, irrelevance, need, viability, etc.?
Actually, we are looking for smart meters and we are looking for AMI meters because we want to control. We want to control from our end. We don't want any manual intervention. Even in AMR meters, some manual intervention is there. Man has to move around, not go to the each and every connections, but he has to move around the area. So in AMI meters, we can have real time data. Mm-hmm. What is the consumption of a consumer? And because we have got high end consumer, VVIPs are there. So every time complaints are coming for high amount of bills. So we need to tell them, this is your consumption. They can very much tally with their actual consumptions.
And so you
are looking for
24,000
smart meters. 24,000 connections. We have 101 connections, water connections in our area,
right.
And these are there are 24,000 connections.
Okay, and so you like the idea of smart meters, and when is your what are the timelines?
Timelines, we will be inviting tenders end of this year.
Okay.
And right. Because it's a part of 24/7, so in a one package, we are inviting tender for the meters as well as other component of 24/7. So okay. We will be taking some time. It will be taking some time. Okay. So the process of appointment consultant is going on. And hopefully we will invite tenders for actual work in the month of January 2021.
Okay, Mr. Virendra Kumar, if I can come to you, sir, what is your own opinion or perspective on smart metering in terms of viability, in terms of relevance, in terms of utility, in terms of cost benefit analysis? Kumar?
Yes.
What is your opinion on smart metering in terms of viability, in terms of relevance, in terms of need, utility, cost benefit analysis?
Actually, when we installed these 3 lakh AMR meter, when we started the installation of these meters sometime in 2013, the public acceptability is very low. to these AMR meter or even to the electromagnetic and considering electromagnetic or ultrasonic meters. So considering the public demand, we or policy of DJB, we plan to ensure 100% metering by only mechanical meter only as of now, though policy is still under deliberation and finalization.
And what is your own opinion? I understand the public was against it, but what is your opinion from your from DJB standpoint? Is that a good thing?
If you ask me sincerely, basically, what is the DJB objective? DJB objective is to bill the consumer on actual meter reading basis.
Right.
So, be it mechanical meter or be it electromagnetic or be it ultrasonic. These almost have a variation of 2-3%. This is not a the accuracy level is not much basically reasonably good for mechanical meter also, if you ask me. Basic problem with us is say you can say 35% consumer are being billed on average or without meter. That is a big cause of concern. We want to bring every consumer to the billing network. That is our basic aim.
Okay, and when you go for the new meters, what kind of meters will you go for?
As of now, what we are considering is we are considering two model. One model is that we have as on date we have a panel of say seven brands we have impaneled for use of our consumers, and we are adding more brand also in our panel. We have invited the EOI. We are finalizing our EOI now shortly. In process of finalizing, we will have a by that after finalization, we will be having a some 15 brand on our panel. Any consumer can choose any of that brand and install it. That will be as per DJB policy. We will be giving the consumer an option to install those any meter, working water meter, out of those 15 brands within certain period of time. But if he fails to do so, then we will be installing from our side. For that purpose, okay. Also, we are talking to the meter manufacturers. We are requesting them that you install on behalf of DJB, and okay. We will be paying you.
And these meters will be mechanical meters.
Yes, mechanical only. As of now, we are only pursuing mechanical meter only. As of now, what I am speaking, basically, still policy is still under deliberation, and we'll be taking a final some this matter. I discussed sometime in March with our senior management, but due to this lockdown, could not be finalized, and we'll be finalizing shortly in a month or so.
Mr. Gopalakrishnan, if I can come to you and ask you not just based on Coimbatore. But the fact, ask you about based on your Tamil Nadu experience as well, because you've been there for a long time. What is your own opinion on smart metering in terms of viability, utility, need, cost-benefit analysis, etc.?
Yes, sir. Now, coming to the metering technology, we have mechanical multi-jet meters and other advanced thing like ultrasonic or electromagnetic. In the case of mechanical multi-jet meter, as per the IS, for 15 mm meter, the minimum flow is 32 liters per hour. So, almost all the cities in our country are at present having intermittent. We are gradually moving on to 24/7, and as part of that, Coimbatore has awarded the work for 24/7 project. It is on with 32 liters per hour in 24 hours. A service connection can deliver 750 liters of water. The per capita supply limit for per person is around 135. So, a family of four can draw his requirement without recording in the meter at all. He can practically draw free of cost if suppose he can fine tune his meter to record below the minimum flow. That but class C meter has a minimum flow rate of 16 liters per hour, but I believe it is not in use in India. others have to confirm. Then coming to the ultrasonic and electromagnetic, they claim their starting flow is as low as 2.5 liters per hour on the, in the case of electromagnetic, and ultrasonic around 10 liters per hour or something like that. So they are reasonable. That could be, that is about the metering technology. About data communication,
sir, I'll come to communication separately. I have a separate discussion on communication.
Okay, sir. That AMR.
That's a big.
Shall I continue on AMR?
Yes, sir.
Yes. AMR. There are two options. One, either walk through or drive by, and also AMI from that online data always available. My thing is, are we going to control individual house delivery? If suppose we are not going to control the system, do we need online data for individual household? We have, the purpose of the meter is only for billing the consumption. Our billing cycle varies from once in 2 months to monthly or something like that. So in that case, we'll know that we need data only once in 2 months or 1 month. This thing has to be considered, and again it comes the cost of your effect. Thank you.
Okay. Mr. Poman, if I can come to you as well, what is your own opinion on smart metering and need, viability, cost benefit analysis? Yeah.
Mr. Batra, in our smart city project, so which are under the influence of Smart City Limited, so we are going to procure advanced water metering, that is AMI meter, 9,000 locations. In that also, online water quality monitoring system, so that we are going to establish at 300 locations. So this AMR is also there. So in this technology wise, the energy metering and water pumps in 25 different locations, plants are pumping stations. That also we are going to install the 120 sensors, the pumps for measuring different parameters like pressures, flows, and temperature, etc. So besides this, very good network we are going to establish for citywide. So that there are two types of reading we are taking. One is by walk, and secondly, we are going to establish the LoRa-based technology for this metering, and we are trying to make the all the housing societies where these bulk consumers are there. So installing these meters for taking these readings and all these volumetrics by this LoRa technology. Now, for these different locations for various because this Pimpri-Chinchwad is predominantly the two parts, one is residential, one is industrials. So there are again two, three authorities working here in the distribution of the water for this industry. There is Maharashtra Industrial Department is there. But we are trying to get integrated under one umbrella for this water supply using this technology in our smart city. So that okay. Is about.
Yeah, Mr. Praveen.
Yes, sir. As I told you, actually our current act and regulation says that the water meter to be purchased by the consumer, and it is to be replaced unless when the water authority finds it's not working. That means the meter reader reports as not working then only. So actually we have done a non-revenue water as part of the NRW study. We have done a sample study, and we found that mechanical meter, as of now we are using mechanical meters, class B multijet, and the mechanical meters are reported with an error of 15 to 25%. That means it is more than the allowable limit, it is showing under reading. So first we thought of going into smart meters in a bulk, But later on, when we do the cost benefit analysis, we found that our tariff system doesn't support such a thing, because as I told you, 36 lakh connections we have. Out of that, 92% are domestic connections. Rest only 8% is only for commercial and industrial and building construction purpose and all these things. So 92% connections being in the domestic, and the tariff for domestic is ranges from 4 rupees per kiloliter, that means per 1000 liter MQ, 4 rupees per MQ to 40 up to 50 kiloliter consumption, 14 per KL. So up to 15 KL, the tariff is something like you have to pay less than 100 rupees per month. And we found that more than 60% of our domestic consumers are in that range. So that means there are two options for us to go for smart meter. Now, as of now, consumer is buying, we have to modify the regulation such a way that we will insist for smart meters. That means it will add up to the cost of the consumer. As of now, because the consumer is at liberty to buy anything from the open market, provided it is having a BA certification, it's having class B and multi-year, they are opting for different types of meter. Maybe they will be sacrificing on the quality. But when you insist that you should buy smart meters, it is an added burden to them, more than the tariff revision. Second thing is, out of that, we should buy the meter and get it through installment payment. Get the cost back through installment payments in the monthly bill. So that way, I told you, most of the consumers are in the less than 15 KL range. The average earning per consumer is around 100 rupees. Out of that, some 30 to 40 rupees is going for meter reading, billing, all those things. Even if we eliminate, unless we get additional 100 rupees, at least 100 rupees, we'll not be able to do a cost balance. So that means the error in meter should be more than 100% or more than 70% to accommodate for this. But our study indicates that if the error is only 25%, maximum is 25%, and 15 to 25%. So what we took is that a decision that we should classify the consumers. We got in a point that more than 500 KL consumption per month, that is 500 MQ per consumption, whether it is domestic or non-domestic, is worth to go for a smart meter. So as part of Smart City project and Amrit project, we have started procuring smart meters. And total, if you take the percentage or if you take the numbers, it is around 5,000 only, if total connections which are having more than 500 MQ consumption per month. So that is the policy. Around 500 meters we are going to purchase in as part of Smart City project, and around 500 are on the way in the part of Amrit project. So, and we have to actually finalize the technology, as Gopalakrishnan sir, the communication systems, all these things are yet to be finalized.
Okay, if I can go to Mr. Jagtap before I come to Mr. Vaidya. Mr. Jagtap, why did you decide to go for the smart meters?
Yeah, as we heard that every city has different issues. We have some different type of issue that as per 135 LPCD, we should use around 850 to 900 MLD of water. But as on today, we are not using meter, and for residential properties, we are charging them on lump sum basis. As on today, our water consumption is around 1200 to 1400 MLD against 900. That is the main issue for us. And our city area is quite hilly area. So we are paying around 130 crore light bill per year. We are buying this much 1200 MLD water from irrigation department. We are paying to them also. By considering all these issues, and previously we have some 40,000 mechanical meters which are installed, and that meter installation was the responsibility of consumers. But if we study, if we see that any event that mechanical meters are, around 50%, 50 to 60% of meters are faulty at any event. So by considering all these points, we took decision to go for a smart meter. In that, we'll save the electricity bill, we'll save the water cost. Then this smart meter, which we have selected, it will resolve, it will help us to resolve the contamination issue also, because it has some reverse flow alarm is there. It counts reverse flow also. That reverse flow means from consumer line, that water comes from consumer line to our main line. It is the main problem for contamination. And if we see that previously for 40,000 meters, we have around 30 to 35 meters are required for taking the acquiring the reading. If for this AMR meter will reduce that reading acquisition cost also. By considering all these issues, we have decided to install AMR meters only.
Okay. Mr. Vaidya, if I can come to you, based on what you've heard and you've been patient enough listening to all this, what are your comments and, you know, responses to some of the issues people have raised?
I think, you know, it's great to hear from utilities what challenges they face. What I would like to put it in a point of way where, you know, it's basically what India, from the Indian point of view, there is an intermediate water supply, there is low pressure, meter are installed in metering pit, water quality, dust, particles. And as Mr. Gopalakrishnan said, you know, the per capita consumption is 135. And we need meters to get solve our these problems. Okay. So when we say that per capita consumption is 135, we need meters which can record at such a low flow conditions, or the meters which can design and operate in intermediate water supply. It doesn't measure air. Yeah, most of the utilities were saying that there is a failure percentage of mechanical meter, which is in a tune of 30-35%. Mr. Jagtap said it's around 50%, and these are the reasons, you know, water quality, dust particles, air in the pipe because of the intermediate water supply. And to add to it, now coming back, these are some of the technology limitation. You know, it's not about that one specific metering vendor has any issue or a quality issue. It's about limitation about the technology. And that's how the next technology has came, where, you know, people are talking about static meters, be it ultrasonic, electromagnetic. These are the next generation technologies, which are solving your these practical problems in the field. Now, coming back to whether it is making sense in terms of, you know, ROI, I would say that meter should not look meter as an only a billing tool. Okay, this the expectation from these meters have been increased now. It's no more just a billing tool. It is helping you in many other way, where, you know, it is one of the tool which is being used for NRW reduction, where you know, you have this data logger, you can monitor the data every hourly basis, and it helps you in reduction of NRW, doing your water balancing, water audit. And as Mr. Jagtap said, you know, percentage of water saved is percentage of the electricity paid to your electricity utilities, or paid to your the irrigation department. So when we calculate the ROI, we should not just think that, okay, we should not burden consumer just because it's a billing tool. We should also look at from the different angles where it can bring on the NRW down. And once you bring down your NRW down, you know, you will be able to supply more water to the consumers, or maybe you will be easily shift to 24/7 waters, because right now almost most of the water utilities are in the range of 45% to 50% NRW loss. So, you know, you can imagine, you know, you will have more water when you reduce the NRW. So the point is, the smart meter is not only a billing tool, it can be used for other purpose of NRW reduction, doing AMR. You know, this brings really value to the water utility.
Okay, let me go to the issue of communication that was raised by Mr. Gopalakrishnan. So I'll go to him first. Mr. Gopalakrishnan, communication platforms in the context of the kind of meters we use, and also in the context of the meter reading practices that we might have, or in the context of the issues that we might have with meter reading. What is your thinking on communication platform, and is communication an issue or not an issue? For example, in electricity, we have often found that communication platform, there hasn't been, communication communication technologies have not always been, have been adequate. But in the case of water, Mr. Kapalakrishnan, what is communication an issue at all, and what is your opinion on all this?
Meter reading has to reach the management for monitoring and billing anything. Different options are somebody taking manual recording the meter readers manually and transmitting it to the office by through his mobile phone, or writing in a register and taking it to office, something like that. There are so many options. At present, it is being recorded in a register, and he reaches the ward office and makes data entry in the system, from which the billing the department raises the bills, and all those things are taking place at present. The next option is AMR, instead of AMR, our concessionaire proposes manual meter reading can be taken, and it can be recorded on the mobile phone on the spot, from where data reaches the system and further processing can be done, either quantum metering or recording the data, billing and all those things. The third one is AMR, in which the meter transmits the data to a handheld device, which can either be walked through or drive by, and data can be collected. Again, it reaches the office and the billing is done. And the next option is AMI, in which there are so many communication options are being offered. LoRa, GPS enabled, Wi-Fi, and something like that. But from our study so far on selecting the options, almost any data communication option cost me not less than 25 rupees per month per meter, whereas with a manual meter reading it is in the range of 5 rupees per month per meter only, almost 5 times costlier. So we have to take a decision whether to go in for that AMI with such a costly things. What is the cost benefit analysis we have to carry out? Okay. And also reliability of the different communication methods being used. Most of the offers we receive have not been tested for such a huge meter. You see, we have to read 150,000 meters over the project area, but so far I have not come across anyone offering the existing system where you have 5,000 or 10,000 meters are on AMI. So unless it is proven, we are afraid we cannot take a risk of putting the 150,000 data on a GSM or a LoRa or whatever it is. That is the status as on now.
Before I go to Mr. Kumar for his thoughts, Mr. Vaidya, any response to that?
I think, yeah, Mr. Gopalakrishnan made a valid point, okay, because yes, the communication technologies are changing, I would say every year. People were talking about 2G, then people started talking about 3G, 4G, and this I have seen in electric sector also. People went ahead with CDMA modems, and suddenly the telecom operators stopped CDMA services, and all their investment went out. So when we select the communication technology, we need to see the factors. I would say it should be designed for the utility purpose and not for generic IoT type of thing. you know, considering it has been designed for water utilities, you know, it has to communicate with the battery operated meters. So power consumption plays a major role. It should be reliable, as Mr. Gopal Krishnan said. And he is right, you know, we cannot take risk when the technology is not been proven. Okay, we don't want to be a guinea pig of certain technologies. So yes, small pilots are really fine, but I totally agree that we really need something which has been designed for utility, which has been reliable, supported by the metering vendor, because finally it's a collaboration between a metering vendor and the communication service provider. So they have to go hands in hand. Personally, I feel that it's like instead of running marathon, walk before you run. Yeah, it's better to start doing with AMR and then shift to AMI. Maybe that's probably one should go.
Yeah, Mr. Virendra Kumar, what is your view based on your experience? Sir, you have to unmute yourself.
AMR water meter, I apprise you. Some Itron meter were 1.2 lakh. Rather, Arad meter, we plan to procure 1.8 lakh and then we curtailed our supply 2.9 lakh only. We could not even complete the awarded scope of work itself, you can say so, because of the public resistance.
I understand, so, but what from a communication experience that you had, what's your view?
Communication also, you can say there is a huge gap between the as suggested by Mr. Gopal Krishnan, that there is a huge gap between the general mechanical meter and the AMR meter itself, you can say so. So it is costing, and here the labor is very cheap in India. So we are also by manual, we are able to get the bill 5 rupees or 6 rupees per connection. So that is very costly affair for us to adopt the AMR technology.
All right. Okay.
And to eliminate the complaint that reading error may be there, we have introduced a tab system. Our meter reader goes with the tab and he captures the data there and gives the bill there itself to the consumer in its presence. So that issue has been addressed, or the consumer has the option to get a pic of the his reading on his mobile and send us on mail, and bill is automatically generated to his K number. So billing part issue has been addressed on that point. So AMR meter, we faced more flack from the public than getting the benefit out of it. Though as a trial, we are again trying. I discussed the issue today in the morning. My friend is dealing with the one ADB project of rehabilitation of Wazirabad WTP. We are again attempting AMR water meter. And in Chandraval, upcoming project of Chandraval, we are adopting this mechanical meter only. Okay.
Mr. Poman, you come obviously with a smart city experience as well, and so you deal with communication platforms much more so than just with water. So what is your perspective on communication platforms and communication technologies for water metering?
So the communication point of view, because Pimpri Chinchwad, that is basically using this AMR technology, and whatever the readings we are taking, so we having developed this mobile app based technology where this the meter reading is taken, the photos will be sent to our central server, and from this reading all the billings are either spot billing or on the website billing or mobile app billing. So basically the communication technology which for that by these they are taking, and for that the cycle for this consumer, household consumer, is the quarterly 3 months months, and for the industrial use that is per month. But basically, we are going to shifting in the smart city with the help of this Jhelum technology for the AMI, the smart metering. And in this smart metering, the infrastructure is going to create for this communication with the rightly said GSM and GPRS technology with the LoRa-based infrastructure, which is already having in our city. And for that, there should have a two-way communication between our control and command center by the IoT-based devices we are using for smart city. And ultimately, we are trying this the online measuring of this reading, then online for this using electric, heat, gas, or water consumptions, which are there. Area wise, then society wise. So we are trying by these two way channels under the smart city. But these are the meters and the that is called as grid networks for these RTUs. So that having the robust technology which are already here in the Pimpri city. But we are trying for this communication protocol, which are established in our smart city.
Okay, Mr. Gupta, what are you? How are you doing this?
Mr. Batra, I had COVID-19 this VC at 4 o'clock, so I am leaving now. This okay. Permission.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Poma. Appreciate your being. Yeah. Greatly appreciated. If I can ask you, what's your experience with the, or what's your plan for the?
Question is for me.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
The question is for me.
Yes, Mr. Gupta.
I'm not. Okay. Actually, some problem is there. I'm just.
Yeah, I can hear you. Mr. Gupta, we can hear.
You are hearing?
Yes.
Okay, okay. Some battery problem is there. So,
okay.
So, actually, hello.
Yes, sir.
We have no issue actually. We have a very compact area. And we are in midst of Delhi, so communication is not a problem for us. And basically, we are serving the high-end people, VVIPs, and we have to deal with them. And connections are only 24,000 connections, and our bulk metering is also there with DGB. We take water from DGB, and it is all. Online metering is there, so right. It is working well.
So not
19 locations.
Yeah, let me go to Mr. Jagtap.
No problem with the communication.
Yeah, Mr. Jagtap, what is the going for? Plan? Sorry, sir.
Yes.
Sorry,
Mr. Gupta. Hello.
Yes, Mr. Gupta.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Go ahead. We can hear you, sir.
So we have got no problem for this communication. So we have decided to go for AMI meters. And because we are this metering replacement of metering is a part of 24/7, where we are also replacing the connections also. So connection leakage from the service connections is also a part of NRW reduction. So this is a effort,
right?
Within that 24/7, yes. We are going for that.
Yes, Mr. Jagtap, if I can ask you, Mr. Jagtap, what is the communication plan that you have? Because you're going in for smart meters in a big way.
Yeah, as on today, as per our tender, we have planned for 1/16, because at the time of tendering, we was not having that much knowledge of fixed network. So we have planned for work by and we have that company has given us a demo for fixed network also. And for 800 meters, that fixed network system is also working fine from last 3-4 months. And I think we can shift from 1/2 a fixed network also at any time as per requirement.
Okay, Mr. Praveen, for you have a small plan for 5,000. I think you mentioned. So, what kind of communication would that be using, Mr. Praveen? Sir, you have to unmute yourself, please.
Yeah. Okay. I have been muted by the organizers. Sorry.
Sorry about
that. Actually, we have plans for both in the distribution end, at the consumer end, as well as the transmission end also. Transmission end, actually, we had as part of Jika project, we had been planning to introduce smart meters in almost all water supply from tanks and major treatment plants. And that tender has been floated, and one Bangalore company has quoted. And actually, there was some problem with the interfacing software. The meter data management software and the communication couldn't be progressed, and the work is still pending. One thing. Second thing, what Gopalakrishnan sir and Amit has told, I will classify the communication as communication plus power. That is the issue we have yet to solve. Because if you take the electricity, they can draw the power from their own line. But for us, if you want to measure the flow from a tank or water treatment plant, we have to harness solar power. Sometimes KCB or electricity power will not be there. So that way, power is as an issue. And related with communication, if you have an RF for GSM or DP, other latest technology, the power consumption varies. So we couldn't, if you take, and we don't have a successful model in India as of now, as of my knowledge, we couldn't, because the companies who came couldn't demonstrate that this is successful. Because sometimes if you go for GSM, they couldn't guarantee us the battery backup for some 5 years or 10 years or so, what we demand. If they say, then you go for RF. Like that, we don't have a proven communication technology in the domestic side smart meters in India, as I think it's going on trial and error. And second, as I told you, we utilities mainly have softwares of billing consumer side. So when you adopt this system, we'll be only using the smart meters for a very low percentage of consumers who are on the higher end consumption. So interface between the existing software and the meter data management promoted by the companies is we are finding. Because with the Amrit, we have 396 smart meters installed, but we don't have an interface. The interface is still under problem. We couldn't get an interface for linking our billing software with the meter data communicated from the meter. So I think these things, power, communication, and the interface, these three has to be looked in total, so that a better solution can be adopted.
Okay. Mr. Vaidya, any thoughts you have on communication technologies and platforms? Yeah, go ahead, Mr. Vaidya. Mr. Vaidya, we're not able to hear you. Maybe we'll go when he comes back on. Mr. Vaidya, if you are able to hear us, perhaps you can. Megha, can you help him out? Give him a call. Okay. Meanwhile, let me just. Okay. Mr. Vaidya, did you hear us? Sorry about that. The other day we had Zoom, everything worked fine, but now we have to go to webinar because of Zoom issues, and other platforms are not as
so, where the urban area, where the density is more. It's going to be difficult. So there are different models, I would say, AMR, AMI, but the time here is, yes, you know, we need to adopt the next generation technologies and try to be there for the smart metering deployment.
Okay. Mr. Vaidya, there is a question for you from Saurav Dasta Patnaik. We are now going to take questions from the audience. Can you please highlight any major metro where you have used and deployed integrated meeting network with smart meters? Any town of over 100,000? HSC.
Okay, can you repeat the question, please?
Yeah, this is from Saurav Das Patnaik of Swachh Environment. Mr. Vaidya, can you please highlight any major metro or any city where you have used and deployed integrated metering network with smart meters? Any town of over 100,000 households?
As Mr. Jagtap said, you know, Pune is the first city which is moving for the smart meters, you know, with an integrated approach. But the deployment is still on. But if you see the global experience, yes, in Saudi, Dubai, then Thames Water is one of the classic example where we have a smart meter deployment with AMI for 3 million meters, and it's a 15 years contract. We need to serve the complete end to end support for next 15 years with this SLA sign off. So worldwide, yes, but in India, the smart meters has just started. A few utilities had moved on. So reference in India is very low, but yeah, globally it's yes.
Question from Mr. Virendra Kumar. Mr. Kumar, one of the persons in the audience is saying, currently with COVID-19 pandemic, house-to-house meter reading is a challenge. Will DJP revisit the strategy for recording on meter reading in major authorized colonies with good record of billing?
No. Due to COVID, what we have decided, we have already issued the bill on average consumption for the last quarter or so. Okay. As regard to changing the strategy, you want to say so. As I have apprised you, we ordered for 3 lakh AMR meter sometime in 2013. We had to curtail it to 2.1 lakh, number one. Right. Number two, we have already apprised you that we will be installing AMR meter only in the ADB project area, that is Wazirabad project area. That project has a provision of AMR water meters. Right. And simultaneously, another project of Chandraval has a non-AMR water meter.
Okay.
And we have outsourced 3 PPP area where we have a conventional these non-AMR meters, no smart meter there also, in all 3 PPP areas also.
Okay.
Now coming to the rest of the area, leaving those Chandraval, Wazirabad and 3 PPP, rest of the area, as I have apprised you, that we foresee a gap of, say, you can say 8 lakh meters. For those 8 lakh meters, though you can say so that smart meter is a good concept, but then our first aim is just to ensure 100% metering. As of now, we are without meter in 35% consumer.
Right. So that's your first priority. So
accuracy is second part. Accuracy is second part. First of all, we should ensure 100% metering.
Okay. All right.
I don't know who has raised this question, but yeah, it's a great thought. I think yes, you know, with AMR, you can keep a social distance, you know. When the entries will be restricted at consumer premises, AMR really makes sense for COVID-19 type of situation.
Okay.
AMR, we did not have a good experience as far as our experience with the one of the supplier of the ARAD is concerned. That created a lot of mess for DJB.
Yeah.
Thousands of complaints. So maybe technology issue, maybe whatever implementation issues, maybe consumer issues. So somehow now we have been for last one year only, we have been settling down rather.
Okay.
We had a lot of issues on the AMR meter. So we don't want to repeat that mistake. Our basic aim is, as I apprised you, that first of all consumer meters, say 8 lakh or 7 lakh or 9 lakh meter, whatever are there, all should be metered. That is the first mandate for us. We will be installing, rather we will be giving the opportunity to the consumer to select their own brand. If they don't do, then we will be enforcing it also in next year or so. That is our basic mode.
Thank you, sir. Question for Mr. Gupta, Sanjay Gupta. You mentioned that NDMC would prefer to have completely automated meter recording system and integrated data communication and management. Would you like to examine integrated scope of meter study, meter supply, network plan, upgrade, meter reading?
Can you repeat?
Yeah, it's a long question. I'm reading it. It says it's from somebody in the audience. You mentioned that NDMC would prefer to have completely automated meter recording system with integrated data communication. Now the question goes on. Would you like to examine the integrated scope of meter supply, network plan, upgradation, automation, meter reading and NRW management all together for at least 5 to 7 years from a consortium of suppliers and operators? Would you
actually last I'm not able to hear.
Yeah. Just sir, what he saying, what the person is saying is that would you be open to looking at considering a integrated scope which includes meter supply, includes network plan, includes upgradation, includes automation, includes meter
reading. Yes.
So you'll be open
actually,
to
actually we are going for an integrated plan.
Okay.
Which includes basically, our aim is to for NRW reduction and 24/7 water supply. In that, we are ensuring the meter management recording of the consumption online, and also at the same time, when we are replacing the meters, we will be replacing the connections also from ferrule to meter. So it is a major source of NRW part.
Okay.
So we are doing that also, and we are also augmenting the lines also. We are creating the DMS and we are looking for NRW reduction in the range of 10 to 15%.
Okay.
Which is presently 40% in our area.
Question for Mr. Vaidya, is it possible to convert or enable AMR meter to AMI facility?
AMR meter to AMI, you said?
Yeah, convert or enable AMR meter to AMI facility.
Yes, so these meters, you know, the smart meters which has inbuilt radio, you can convert it with AMR to AMI. Like, you know, Mr. Jagtab has said that, you know, they have received the meters which are AMR meters currently having walk by drive by system, but the same meter with the same infrastructure, you don't have to replace the meters, but you can upgrade it to AMI in future.
There's a question for various panelists. Are corporations planning on a joint policy document of standard specifications for smart meters, as in the case of smart energy meter? Maybe I can go to the Gopala question first. Any thoughts, sir, of standard specification for smart meters like there are for smart energy meters?
Hello?
Yes, Mr. Gopala Krishnan, is there any initiative there for standard specifications for smart water meters like what there are for smart energy meters?
No, we are not on it.
Okay, Mr. Jagtap, are you aware of any such initiative? Sir, you have to unmute. Okay, he's out, will be coming back then. Yes, Mr. Jagtap, are you aware of any initiative to have standard specifications for water meters, smart meters?
No, specifications, we are not, we are using that international specifications only, or Indian specifications only.
Okay, Mr. Vaidya, are you aware of any such efforts?
Yeah, so look, you know, as far as majority of the water utility, while they mention the MID certification, which is commonly adopted by many countries, it's a European standard, and been adopted by many Indian water utilities as well. So MID speaks about, you know, not only metrology but also the product design as well as the manufacturing processes. So it makes sure that your product design has been verified as per as metrology performance as well as the manufacturing process. So MID certification is very common and is being getting adopted by a majority of the water utilities in India, which is really good probably. As far as communication technologies are concerned, yeah, that's a separate thing. And there is no standard as such. Anyone is working on communication. I have not seen in recent past, but metrology definitely is standardized more or less.
Mr. Virendra Kumar, question is, DJB planning to achieve 24/7 water supply in selected DMAs? This must be somebody outside Delhi, because of course I'm familiar with some of that in Delhi, but could you answer the question for people outside Delhi?
As of now, we have outsourced three project areas to the private operator. One is Nangloi WTPPP area, having a consumer base of around 2.5 lakh to 3 lakh. There we have given him raw water to the operator. Then he brings the raw water to the treatment plant. From treatment plant, then he distributes to the consumer, collects the revenue also, maintains the entire system, including metering part also. So it has a mandate to convert it into 24/7 also. So one project is Nangloi PPP name. Second project, there we have a treatment process is also with the operator itself. Second part is Malvi Nagar UGR, Malvi Nagar PPP area. There we have a consumer base of around 50,000. In that 50,000 consumer base, we give him the treated supply in a UGR, Malvi Nagar UGR. From there, he distributes to the its command area. In that pocket, the mandate of that also is to convert it into 24/7. Only Malvi Nagar, we have just rolled out, say you can say two pockets having consumer base of 800 consumers. We are supplying 24/7 for last 2-3 years. Consumption is very high as on date also. If you ask me, it is 270-280 LPCD. We don't have that much water. We are pursuing with the operator either to convince the resident or persuade the resident to be within the normal standard of 170 or 175 LPCD, but that is not there. Then we plan to either redesign our tariff also to see what we can do. And second part is, while introducing the 24/7 initial phase, the water consumption becomes very high. Very high means it goes to 500 LPCD, 600 LPCD also. So gradually it has to be brought down by reducing the losses from the overhead tank, underground tank, and all this network. So we doesn't have that much water to roll out the 24/7 in Malvi Nagar, because initially it will require twice the quantity what we are supplying today. So we are discussing with our management to at least spare some quantity of additional water, so that we can roll out 24/7 in pocket wise, if not entire area. So my management has now assured me that we'll be giving some water, additional water for Malvi Nagar sometime in August, September. Then we'll be rolling out, say, 5,000 consumer of Saket. We have made all the preparation and we'll be rolling out 24/7 there. And then Malvi Nagar pocket also having a consumer base of 10-12,000. There also we plan to roll out 24/7. Third project we are having in Vasant Vihar, where consumer are around 8,000 consumer. There also we are giving the water to the operator in VR. From there he is distributing. There also he has also hardly roll out 24/7 in a consumer base of 400 consumer, West End colony, very small colony. So only three pockets of, say you can say 400 each, three pockets of 1200 consumer are getting the water of 24/7. Now we have made the preparation for 24/7, some pocket in Najafgarh also. We have been asked to see the effect of 24/7 in rural pocket also, or in poor habitation also, see the per capita consumption, what is the per capita consumption there in the poor habitation. There we plan to roll out the 24/7 sometime in, say, after this COVID period is over. We have made all the arrangements. We'll be starting the 24/7 very soon.
Okay, thank you, sir. There's a question here. This is for Mr. Vaidya, I think. Would building up AMI, AMR infrastructure too costly for a small town with population of 50,000 and 10 to 12,000 connections?
So it 10, 15,000 is a good numbers probably in terms of, you know, even if you talk about AMR and AMI, right. It's a good numbers, you know. If it is less than 1,000, then I would say probably it makes different case, but 10, 15,000 makes sense for any AMR, AMI technology.
Okay. Next question, which I will give to Mr. Praveen. Sir, based on the experience, how long does the mechanical meter survive and what is the average interval for replacement?
Yeah, it depends. Actually, we have not done a thorough study where random sampling reveals that a meter lasts even for more than 10 years. But the problem is that when we studied the reliability or the accurateness of the meter, it doesn't depend on the age actually. Even meters with less than 2 years are showing more error than meters older than 7. So we couldn't have we were done a specific sampling study in 3 cities, and based on this, we couldn't directly infer anything which could prove us that it is the age that depends on the accuracy or nothing like that.
Okay. There is another question which says, are there any metrics or report available that when intermittent supply gets converted to 24/7, what happens to water loss? Anyone who has any opinion on this? Mr. Vaidya, do you want to take a shot at that?
Okay, I believe, you know, globally also, if you really see in terms of the NRW loss or the water loss, yeah, some countries, though they have 24/7, they have the loss of more than 30-40%. So it's not directly linked with intermediate water supply or the 24/7. The problem with intermediate is, you know, it put pressure on the network. Okay, it really is, you know, the life of the pipe gets reduced because of the transients of in the pressure and all. So, yeah, but nothing to link with the losses.
Yeah, Mr. Kumar, were you going to say something?
Just now that when we introduced the 24/7 in our now Jeevan Vihar pocket, their per capita consumption shot up to 600 LPCD. And after what we found that over a tank are overflowing and there is a massive leakage from the underground tanks also. So by controlling those leakages itself, we have now been able to reduce the consumption to around 260 LPCD. So that 260 LPCD is also very high, but that is actual consumption. That is not a loss, I mean to say so. So yeah. Loss was through leaking underground tank and leaking overhead tank and fittings.
Okay. So 24/7 situation, it's quite possible that you might have enough of flow where smart meters become viable. Right.
Smart meter, though smart meter, what I want to submit is that smart meter is a second priority for me.
So I understand. I'm not talking about.
We have a very high NRW. I apprise you that we have an NRW of 45%. That is a very big high NRW. We should ensure 100% metering to bring it to some semblance. I'm giving you one more example here. In my Malviya Nagar PPP area, we don't have a smart meter. We have been able to control the NRW to around 20%.
Right. Because you have a private operator.
Without smart meter.
Is that because you have a private operator there?
Yes. With better management, you can say so.
Okay. All right. But anyway, I think perhaps it's not relevant for Delhi, but it does seem to me that if you have a higher flow, that means higher consumption, whether that's desirable or not, but certainly would mean that it'll enable. Any final thoughts from you, Mr. Jagta?
As per our experience, if we are going to 24/7 or when we are using that smart meters, we have to adopt that telescopic billing system also. for if you need to save the water, then you should go for telescopic billing system. Now, as on today, we have a telescopic billing system, means up to 135 LPCD, there is a subsidized rate. And after that, as that consumption goes on increasing, that tariff goes on increasing. So okay. That will help to reduce the consumption of water, and hence for it will help us for NRW also.
Okay, and you don't foresee any resistance to smart meters in your area?
No, there is a lot of resistance for smart meters, but we are trying, and we don't have other alternative because some of farmers and some of activities has launched case against us because that we are using the more water than CPHU norms. So that's why we have to go where we don't have any other alternative to enforce the metering system.
Okay, all right. I think it's been a very, very interesting discussion. Obviously, different regions have different priorities, have different realities, and therefore have different solutions that make sense for them. I know that we would have loved to have had this discussion in person in Delhi, but then again, I have a feeling that if you were doing this in Delhi, some of you would not have had time to come to Delhi. So in a way, this platform that we've been forced to use actually has allowed us to get input from all over, because some of you would not have been able to, you know, leave your office for a day or two and come to Delhi. But this way, you're able to at least give us an hour or so from your office. And we are very, very grateful for that. So thank you, all of you. Thanks also to the audience. I saw the audience was glued right throughout. I think it was between 73 and 77 pretty much right throughout. And pretty much most of them are from ULBs, the audience. There are some technology providers. Thank you all, and thank you Census also for supporting this. And we are going to have one more series, one more webinar in this series, which will be on 24/7. Supply we may approach one or two of your organizations for the same, but thank you again very, very much. We're closing the meeting now. Thanks again, sir.
Thank you.